Hey folks, it's Gaz from PMTV UK here again, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make Synthwave! So in short, Synthwave is quite simply put a tribute to the sound of the 80s. It's not actually music from the 80s, but it sounds like it is. It's a big tribute essentially. So when you think of the sound of Synthwave, think of like Outrun, your old favorite classic like video games from the 80s. Huge synth sounds, you know, from like Korg or the Roland Juno, the Jupiter, all that kind of stuff. And traditional drum machines like Lindrum, like the 808, all that kind of stuff. The genre has picked up pace massively. It's possibly one of the biggest growing electronic music genres that I can think of. Some of the most watched TV shows out there, such as Stranger Things, are essentially a synthwave soundtrack throughout it, using some of the classic instruments that would have been used at the time to create that sort of music. However, not everyone can afford or has the space for racks of analog synths and modular gear, effects boards and whatnot. Luckily for us in the 21st century, we have quite a lot of choice in how we make our music. Today, we're going to be using the Machine Mark III. We're going to be using the Machine Jam as well. These controllers are both fantastic and capable controllers that you can use VST synthesizers with, so software emulations of classic like synthesizers and things like that. The really cool thing to remember about this as well is that anything that you do inside your machine, or if you've got an audio interface with a MIDI out on it, in time, if you get round to buying analog synths, you can actually just MIDI out your patterns from your old VSTs and chuck them into your synthesizer and play them back in. So don't feel like if you're creating loads of music just now on this, it's going to be invalid when you get a synthesizer. You can just essentially, the same way that guitarists do reamping, you can do exactly the same with synthesizers and MIDI notes. So without further ado, enough of me talking, let's get into the sound of Synthwave, starting with the drums. There's no written rule as to correct BPM for synthwave. Every style of synthwave and every artist has a different idea of how fast they want their track to be or how heavy hitting it is, so to speak. As a rule though, anywhere from 80 to 140 is great for synthwave. That'll allow you to get faster paced dance style tracks or slower paced like more synthy ballads, you know, with lots of nice pad sounds on them. So the drums are an integral part to the sound of synthwave. They need to sound old school, for want of a better way of putting it. As I say, classic 808, 909, Emu, Lindrum stuff, that is absolutely fantastic and it will give you that kind of sound. So I've got some Lindrum samples here which I used to make a lot of synthwave myself, just to let you hear how it kind of sounds and the sound you should be aiming for, in my personal opinion. Let's have a little look here. So we've got our kick. You can hear that it sounds very, very, very 80s. There's no real modern sound to that at all. Then we have our snare. We have our hi-hat, which as you can hear, I've got a bit of reverb on that. We have an open hi-hat, and then we'll have our toms on here as well. So something like... that kind of stuff works. So you don't need to go out and spend a lot of money on drum machines and things like that if you don't want to or you don't have the space. Within most workstations, so Machine, Ableton, Logic, Pro Tools and things, you will find a lot of drum samples already. On top of that, there are a lot of free drum samples online for 808s, indeed even Lindrum stuff, 909s, Emu, all that kind of stuff. You'll be able to find these samples for free, so don't fret. If you don't have anything to start off with, just do a simple Google or check out the library in whichever software that you're using. So what we're going to do here is we're just going to quickly enter in some note information. So essentially, I'm just going to select my kick, which is this one here, and we're going to use the step sequencer just to implement some note information. Something simple like that. What we can do is we can add the pattern length as well. So I'm going to make it 2. Just so we've got a bit more to work around with. So that's a fairly simple, just intro kick kind of pattern. What we can do is we can start adding the snare in as well, so. Nothing serious, it's all about building things up, and synthwave is quite a simple genre. You don't need to overcomplicate it with the drums. The synths and vocal lines and things kind of take over from there, really. So really simple, we've got a kick, we've got our snare. Let's add some hi-hats in somewhere. So we've had some closed hi-hats in, we've got some open hi-hats. So I'm going to duplicate that over there. So this means that I can swap between these two different patterns here. Just to show you how that works, I'm just going to manipulate this a little bit here. I'm going to take off our hi-hats. So we can go to cycle through these and add some synthesizer lines to it and see how that sounds too. Another really cool thing that you can do with your drum samples when you're making synthwave is to use octave up, octave down, to pitch them up, to pitch them down as well. It's particularly handy on the likes of toms. So if we just go to our drum pad here, so A. You'll notice that classic dun 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 dun. You can do it even more on here. Octave down. And you can also note repeat it as well, of course, so you could have it on fours. All that kind of stuff. Whatever sounds good to you, give it a shot. Remember, it's all about experimentation as well. So another really cool thing that'll allow you to get your work done faster, essentially, is to use what we call note repeat mode. So, and I'm going to mention arpeggiating stuff quite a bit during this video as well. But note repeat is essentially the same thing. It just repeats any given note that you're holding down, essentially. So I'm just going to add some 16th in this just to give it a bit more kind of like vibe and a bit more life. And obviously, because these pads are velocity sensitive, I can adjust how much actual note information, or the velocity rather, of the note information that I'm sending on here. Awesome. Cool. Another really cool thing that you can do with the drums as well is to add effects to the drums. So a very popular thing would be to add the likes of a lo-fi effect or you know, some reverb to it. It's good to put it on an auxiliary as well, and to also separate which parts of your kit are going into that auxiliary. The last thing you want is to have lots of lush reverb, which makes the snare and everything else sound really nice, but makes your kick so boomy that you just can't mix it. It's almost impossible. So you need to find a happy medium. If you don't know what lo-fi is, it's essentially taking away like quality. It's making it more crushed. It's taking away all of the fidelity from the sound. Now this is kind of what we want, because the 80s has got a lot of like noise sound, a lot of bit crushing things going on as well. So we can go back into our auxiliary on here. So I'm going to load H, because that's exactly where my auxiliary is located. And inside of H we can go to control. And if you hear that, pretty cool. Awesome. And just remember that these are all automatable as well. So if you've seen any of my previous videos, you will have seen that I've done lots of things with automation, which essentially is programming your track, essentially. It's telling it that at X point you want the reverb to kick in, or that Y point you want the snare to cut out or whatever. You can automate this as well, so it's really cool for transitions. Try using lo-fi to transition between different segments of your song, so between like breaks into choruses and all that kind of stuff as well. Just have fun and experiment with it. So another important thing with drums, and in particular with the synthwave, as there's usually quite a lot going on in terms of instrumentation and effects, is you want to make sure that your drums are all correct levels, that they're not peaking and trying to smash through everything else and causing unwanted distortion. There is a difference between good distortion and bad distortion. And you want to make sure that they're all panned as well, so there's enough space in the environment for you to correctly hear everything that's going on. So with the Machine Mark III, for example, it's really quick and straightforward. You simply just select which group you want. So for example, A on the drums, you then go down there, and this takes us into the individual instrument part where we can pan left, right, we can adjust the volume on the go. And it's just a really awesome visual hands-on way to do your mix, essentially. Other awesome things that you can do are sample your own kick drums. If you're a drummer and you happen to have some acoustic drums around, sample them, mix them all in there. You never know, you could get a very unique sound. Another really cool thing to do is to mess around with filters as well. Exactly. Just don't go too overboard with the filters. The more you go overboard with the filters, the more it detracts from the actual song and what's going on. So just use it to a minimum, but use it right. So having a synth to make synthwave is preferable, but as I say, not everyone has access to a synth. Not everyone has the room to keep a synth. And once you start buying synths, you can't stop. They're like gremlins, they just keep appearing. So yeah, that's why I am using the machine. Now, thankfully, within Machine's library and within the complete select library that comes with Machine, I have some awesome sounding retro instruments on here. I have the likes of the Retro Machines plugin, I have the Monarch plugin, I have Massive as well. Those three plugins are more than enough to get you started with synthwave. There are fantastic sounds in there. Everything from Moog recreations, so you can get that lovely fat Moog bass sound, right the way through to like Juno kind of like sounds and Jupiter sounds as well. So everything from pads right the way through to harsh leads, everything in between. That being said, there are also a lot of different styles of synthesis. Subtractive, FM was particularly popular back in the 80s. So you get like the Yamaha DX. By the way, they do a DX reface now as well. So if you want to get that classic FM kind of like algorithm-y sound, get one of those guys. However, I do feel it's important because synthwave is primarily used with synthesizers and analog synths. I do think it's important to give you a list of a few that I personally use and I find fantastic for making synthwave. So the first one, and probably the most affordable one on the list, would probably be the Korg Minilog. The Korg Minilog is a four-voice polyphonic synthesizer, and it sounds amazing. There's a built-in delay engine inside of it as well, so you don't have to go traipsing around looking for delay pedals and things like that. And it is very reasonably priced as well. We've got a full video on a run through the Minilog, so if you want to hear how it sounds, go and check out Korg Minilog in PMTV UK page. So any Moog product will sound killer for synthwave. It'll give you that lovely gritty sound that a lot of other synths aren't capable of. You don't have to spend thousands to get a nice Moog either. The Moog Minotaur is a very reasonably priced Moog. We also have the Sub 37, we have the Sub 50, the Mother 32. We have videos on the Sub 37 on our PMTV UK channel, so if you do want to check out the sound of that, please do make your way there. For smaller synthesizers that are going to take up a lot of room, we've got the likes of the DO5, the Linear DO5 by Roland, which is like the 80s synthesizer, or one of them. Lots of people would say it isn't, but it is. Also, the Roland Juno DS. Whilst it's not an analog synthesizer, it has some pretty awesome sounds on it. And if you want to get a keyboard that's going to give you pads, strings, choir voices, leads, basses, all that stuff, then it is absolutely killer. And again, it's very reasonably priced. There are loads of other synths that I could name you, but I'm going to stop because I'll be here all day because I'm a huge synth nerd and I need to behave myself and do this video. So in a lot of my previous videos, you guys have been asking me how I make my sounds. I usually use analog synthesizers alongside VSTs to make a lot of my sounds, and I'll actually play a lot of stuff on my synths and try and recreate it using VSTs as well, just to see how close I can get it. For the most part, for these videos, I use Massive because it's an amazing plugin that, as I say, comes standard with these controllers here, so it's not like I'm demonstrating something that you guys aren't able to use. You know, if you have these controllers or if you have Complete Select or whatever, you'll be able to get those sounds. Now, mostly presets, which I've heavily manipulated myself. However, what we'll do is we'll make a wee list of the presets that I've used, and you guys can take it from there and see if you can recreate some of the sounds that we've gone for. Massive is a really awesome, like, three oscillator VST synth plugin that you can do just about anything with. And you can get anything from like that, like 80s FM-y kind of sound through harsh leads and like driving arpeggios and things like that as well. So just to give you an idea of the kind of sound I'm talking about here. So you see what I mean? It's like almost like that kind of glassy, like DX-y, kind of like bouncy sound. So I'm just gonna play this little drum track here. Let's trigger the clip. Exactly, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go back to my instrument group on here. I'm gonna go to keyboard and we're just gonna have a little mess around and just see what kind of melodies we can come up with. Easy as that, simple, straightforward, but it's hard. Next we can add a little bit of an effect onto this too, so let's add a bit of a filter on. We can change whether it's a low pass, high pass, whatever we want. Let's maybe try adding a... So that's just one instrument. So we'll say that that's like a DX-y sound, you know, it's like almost like an FM synth sound. There are other various different synth sounds as well, which we're gonna have a little look at now too. So just with that as the basis, let's see if we can move things forward. So let's try adding in another little synth part. Again, you'll hear that this is 80s is all hell too, I love it. So let's see if we can add something in there just to give it a bit more backing and a bit more kind of like beef. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna mute that other synth track while we have a little listen to this. So you notice that I'm leaving this pattern short because we don't really need to do anything else crazy to it, seeing as we've got this little synth line going sick here as well. Let's chuck a filter back on this, shall we? Can you hear it all coming together now? Go back to our step on our song. Cool. So now we're starting to build it up. We've got synth harmonies, we've got synth lines going on here as well. Let's be bold and brave and move on to the bass. So recurring theme, I'm going to be using massive for the bass as well. And remember, with the machine controller, you can actually manipulate all of the sounds within massive as well. So you can go inside of here, you can move over to massive, and you can actually change, well, everything and add like effects change onto it. Sort out your auxiliaries, all that kind of stuff as well. So with the bass, you can go a number of ways. So there's like guys like Carpenter Brute who have like really fast, like slamming driven bass going, almost as if it's like metal-y kind of sound, just like metal with synths. It sounds really cool. But you've also got stuff like Kavinsky, which uses like a lot slower kind of like dun 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 like. Either way, it doesn't really matter. Whatever kind of like fits into how your song's going, just use that. So dudes like Comtrues, their bass lines are all over the place and they sound absolutely killer. I love it. However, you don't need to go that extreme. So let's just put something very basic in here and see how it works. So you can see whilst I'm playing, I'm able to edit my macro, so I'm able to edit how the synth actually performs exactly the same way as if I had a Korg Monologue or any other synthesizer here. So really, even with the Machine Mark III and the Machine Jam, whilst it's not technically a synthesizer, you have access to all of these beautiful VST plugins, of which the machine gives you all of your macros down here. So you can, if you want to, control how your filter responds, you can add how much chorus you want, drive, any of the parameters inside of Massive you can control on this thing here. So you'll have heard me gradually bringing up the drive, all that kind of stuff as well. It's really awesome. So for those of you familiar with production techniques, and especially techniques in making electronic music, you will probably have already noticed that I've got a compressor on there which is side chaining to my kick. So essentially this is a really cool technique that you can do to allow the track to have more life, as if it's kind of like breathing essentially. So the kick can cut through my bass line, so that's with the compressor on. With the side chain on. If I take the side chain off, you know what I mean? There's like no life, it's just, it sounds cool and you can maybe use it, however it sounds much better. See what I mean? Awesome. So doing that kind of stuff just again leaves more room for you to have fun with your synths and things like that. So let's just gradually try and bring some of these other like instruments that I've got going on into the mix again. Let's try bringing in our synth. We'll gradually bring it in with a filter as well, so it's not too sharp, and just see if it fits well in a mix and whether they sound good together. So they fit in nicely together. It's quite a nice little melody, to be honest with you. So strings and pads, particularly electronic sounding strings and pads, are very important in synthwave as well, as they provide like melodies and provide essentially a backdrop too. So just to give you an idea of what I mean, let's check out this sound here. Let's just try recording that in, see how it sounds. So I also have a compressor on this as well, which I have sidechained again to the kick just to give it that bit of breathing space almost. So with regards to effects that you can use on your synthesizers, delays, massive reverbs that you can automate and control, they are going to be killer, and they're going to bring a lot of life and feeling to your track as well. Remember, it's not about making it sound polished and produced. That's just not synthwave, and it's not really the sound of the 80s. So what we want to do is we want to be making sure that it sounds full, that it's got a lot of character to it, it's got a lot of nice warmth, that it's breathing. So for example, sidechain compressors and things like that as well. One of the most common questions that I get asked, both in the store and in comments, is the difference between polyphonic and monophonic and voices and things like that essentially. So a monosynth is essentially a synthesizer that can play only one note at once as a one voice engine. So the likes of a, you know, like a Moog Sub Fatty or Minotaur or something like that. Some of the mono synthesizers have a dual mode, but essentially they can like split oscillators and things like that to give the representation that there's actually two notes being played. So keep that in mind. Polyphony means essentially the amount of notes that can be played at once. So the Korg Minilog is a four voice polyphonic synthesizer, the Korg Prolog 8 is an eight voice polyphonic synthesizer, so you can play eight notes at once in the engine and produce chords and things like that. In short, get a polyphonic synthesizer if you want to play chords and do lots of cool sequences with different notes. Get a monophonic synthesizer if you're not bothered about all that kind of stuff and you want a really nice, like, kind of raw driving tone. I also get asked a lot on how you connect up synthesizers to equipment like this. This is definitely a video that we can explore in further depth in future, but just very quickly to answer a question, it's very simple. All you need is an audio interface, of which Machine Mark III has. You need a MIDI cable as well, both MIDI in and out, if you want to send and receive information back and forward between your synthesizer and the hardware, or an audio interface with the MIDI in and MIDI out. And you're good to go. All you need to take is the output from that, from your synthesizer into your interface, be it the machine, be it a Scarlett or a UAD or whatever. You just pop the input into there, make sure that this is sending the clock out to the synth, if that's how you want to do things, and voila, it's honestly as easy as that. You make sure that you're sending it out in the correct channel, so it would be channel one in this case, going out of there, back into the audio interface, and you're good to go. The advantages of having a hybrid, like digital, like analog setup is that you can get all of the fantastic sounds of an analog synthesizer, but actually keep it clocked and in sync and in time with everything that's going on inside your favorite digital workstation. So here, machine, for example, it's really cool because I can create some pretty intricate arpeggiated sequences that a lot of synthesizers don't have on them as standard, particularly analog ones. And I can actually send all of these MIDI signals back into the synthesizer as well and create some new sounds. It's pretty awesome. So hopefully this gives you a better understanding of synthwave, how to make it, what equipment is used when you're making it, what effects to use, how to actually transition your track and all that kind of stuff. Hopefully it gives you a better understanding of how to do that. We've got plenty of other videos on the PMTV UK website as well. The YouTube channel, we have how to make grime, how to make trap music. We have hundreds of product reviews, demos, all that kind of stuff as well. Not just synthesizers, guitars, drums, bass, you name it, all that kind of stuff. If you feel like you want to get hands-on or you need any more information, please don't hesitate to pop down to one of your local PMT stores where we'll have tech experts like myself who'll be able to guide you through Machine, Ableton, all those kind of programs and be able to show you how to hook up your gear and make sure you ultimately get the right product. Thanks for taking the time to watch. I've been Gaz. Cheers.